Boko Haram insurgents block road and demand identification documents from road users. Boko Haram's insurgents on Friday reported after attacking some vigilantes and seizing their patrol van, blocked the Damaturu-Gasha highway, looting, searching and demanding identification documents from the road users, an operation that took hours uninterrupted. In a report, the terrorists stormed a community in Tarmuwa, local government area, Kaliari, 10:30 a.m. yesterday, and caused havoc there before taking it to the highway with the vigilantes' patrol vehicle demanding for identification documents from the road users. An eyewitness explained his ordeal with them, stressing that they were looking for anyone with government-related documents. One's question would be that why would they look for government-related documents on the highway? Do they think that they could find any kind of documents there? The article continues. The acting assistant director, Army PR LT Chinonso, in his speech has appealed to the residents of Yobe to remain calm, reassuring the citizens that it's their top priority to see that Yobe is in peace. Meanwhile, the military has appealed for calm, calling on Yobe residents not to be panicked. People have replied to this. Someone said, could you just imagine the army office is saying they should be calm? The next thing you will hear from is that they have replied Boko Haram, Nigerian army, and now the politicians. Another person says, could it be that Boko Haram is winning the war? I mean, if the government cannot effectively tackle them and remove them as threats to society, could it be that they're winning because the Nigerian government has not really tackled or implemented any strategies to take them out and make sure that the country is secure? Another person says, OMG, we are the giant of Africa for nothing. Boko Haram having checkpoints in broad daylight, this is another dimension to terrorism. This is very true, because for Boko Haram to feel like they have the audacity and the infantry to do that in broad daylight shows the confidence they have that nothing will happen to them and they will go unpunished. So what do you guys think? Please put your comments in the comment section below, and do not forget to like and subscribe.